Altieri, CEO and wine lifestyle host of Wine Channel TV. And here at the Chicago Food and Wine Festival, and we're getting ready to sample unlimited food, wine, craft beer, and amazing desserts. And here, wine is much more than just what's in your glass. It's about who you're drinking with, where you're at, and the experiences you gain. So follow me as I show you a view from the bottle. And as I always say, wine is just a conversation waiting to happen. So I'm lucky to be joined by the one and only Ted Brunson of Chicago's Best.
Yeah, man. Thank you.
Great to see you.
It's great to meet you too.
Oh, please. You have the dream job.
Wait a minute now. I mean, I have the dream job for people who love food. You have the dream job for half of the other country because you found a way to go. I've watched your stuff and it's really good.
Oh, thank you.
It's a great idea and I think that it's going to just keep catching on and catching on. Because wine is becoming like, you know, people are really starting to learn a lot about wine.
And I agree.
They want to know more. So you've got it right at the right time. How'd
you're making my day.
How'd you do that?
I drink a lot of wine. Big Italian family.
Oh, there you go.
I hated Wall Street. No.
So you have like...
I got a little list.
At your family's table, you have those big decanters of Chianti with like the woven stuff on the bottom,
yes,
right?
Yes, of course. Yeah. Yes.
And but the checkered tablecloth?
Obviously. Okay. Of course, Altieri is my name.
There you go.
But I want to know about, what about you? Is this something you always wanted to do?
I didn't know that I did.
Really?
But now I
what
do.
Was your past life? I'm curious.
I can't talk about that on camera.
Oh,
no,
God.
No, actually, I've been in TV for like 20 years. And I produced for the first 10 years for everything from sports to lifestyle stuff. And then I started doing freelance reporting and hosting. And I did a lot of sports. But I didn't do anything having to do with food. I grew up in the industry.
Okay.
My parents owned a couple of places. And then, of course, I bartended and
managed
restaurants.
And the family.
So yeah, exactly. La familia, right?
La familia.
So I've done everything there is to do in the restaurant, from like cleaning the toilets to like washing the dishes to cooking to bartending to everything. So when this job came along, it seemed like just the perfect fit, you know?
Huh.
So, yeah.
Wow.
And
look
it beats
at you.
Working.
I agree.
Right?
I agree. And so we're talking
about. I also have a great co-host, Brittany Payton. So.
Oh, you guys are like the dynamic duo.
We
I
try.
Have to say, you gave me some kudos. I love your show. Watch it
Thank
all the
you.
Time because I'm a foodie at heart and then a wino. I need to know, though. So
are
what's
you sure in that order?
Maybe. No, wino then
depending
foodie.
On the day.
Oh, it depends on the day.
Okay.
What is your go-to wine, depending on the day? I mean, you grew up in the business.
I'm
sure you're a wine lover.
I'm not going to give a label, because that would just...
Now, okay, if you're a wine varietal, what would you be?
If I was a what?
If you're a wine, would you be like a zesty Malbec?
I swear to you, I was just about to say I would be a Malbec.
Who knew? You should try. We got a Desenio Malbec over there.
Yeah, with a nice, maybe a fruity front and like a little bit of a spicy.
You may like this though. This is Dave Matthews wine, Dreaming Tree Crush.
Oh, is that right?
Red blend from California. Who knew?
We'll try this in a little bit.
We'll try this.
Yeah.
And the other question was going to be, do you have a wine crib? A wine cellar? We call it wine cribs.
I do not have a wine crib.
Really?
I live in an apartment in Chicago right now, so it's kind of hard to have a wine crib, but that is one of my dreams. I do want to have
a wine crib. And if you had the wine crib, would you be sipping your wine down there in boxers or briefs?
Boxer briefs.
Oh, perfect.
Combine
the two,
right?
I had to ask it.
Yeah.
Sorry.
What about you?
Please, really?
See, she can ask the question to me, but I can't ask her.
No comment. That's all I have to
okay.
say.
All right.
Anyways, I'm looking forward to
it. At least I'm honest.
I try to be.
Okay.
What do you have going on today? So you're hosting the whole festival.
Well, I guess you could say that. Yes. I'm emceeing it and kind of just facilitating it and helping out with the cooking demos and, you know, just chatting like I always do.
Okay.
Scott and Sandy put this event on and they've done a really good job. This is the inaugural event.
Right.
So you've got a lot of kinks to work out in your first event, but it seems like it's got a really good draw right now.
I think so too.
There's some great representation of restaurants and winemakers out here.
Right.
And then also everything from like hot sauce to cookware.
Oh, I tried it.
Else.
It's
yeah.
good.
Yeah.
All right. So I'll make sure to keep getting you some wine.
Do it.
And you keep controlling the party.
Okay.
Keeping everybody
so
going.
What you're saying is you're going to just keep me well oiled?
Yes, that's my job. I could do it. I think I can man up.
Can we say that on camera?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're good.
Well,
cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Cheers. Coming up is our kindergarten wine lesson. You don't always have to splurge on a great bottle of wine. Hey there, I'm Jess Jess of Wine Channel TV, and welcome to the second annual complexity-sponsored New Zealand Wine Day. So we're celebrating fantastic wines and Waitangi Day, and you're here, Sarah Burton from Cloudy Bay. It's an honor to have you here. And so I wanted to ask you something. I know that the big buzzwords in New Zealand is organic and biodynamic. Can you talk to me about that?
Sure. So basically, with New Zealand, it's just a beautiful, pristine country. It's you know, full of rivers and mountains and amazing scenery. And I guess what the whole idea of the organics movement is to really protect the land and really respect the land. So it's all about you know, treating the land as something that really special. So.
And then biodynamic is planting, harvesting according to the lunar cycles?
Biodynamics is organics, but it's also about the dynamic forces of the world is like having an influence on your land.
So gotcha.
The moon, the sun, the planets, everything like that, all having a link to your land. So
when's harvest?
Harvest is about March, April, so come out in March, April. Come
Perfect. Yeah. Cheers to that. Yes. I'm just Jess. As I always say, wine is just a conversation waiting to happen. So the holidays are coming up, but that doesn't mean you always have to splurge on a fancy bottle of champagne to have a great time. You can always pick up something more affordable like a Blumenfeld Sweet Riesling, which I have here today, or some Cava or Prosecco, or visit one of your favorite wine bars. And I'm lucky to be joined by the one and only Candace of Yelp, and you know where all the top places are to go.
I do.
So talk to me about Yelp.
Yelp's a website. It helps connect people to great local businesses, things in their area, where you can basically see what real people are saying about the businesses in your neighborhood. So restaurants, dry cleaners, dentists, everything. So if you're looking up, you can even look up a specific kind of wine on Yelp, and it'll tell you which bars have that. So
wonderful. And You mentioned for the holidays you have something specific going on, right?
Yes.
What is that?
We've actually got a gift guide coming out next week. It tells you about great indie places in the suburbs where you can get gifts and avoid the malls. So places where you can support your local shops and your community and give to others as well.
I love that. And I got to ask you something wine related. Yes. If you were a wine, what would you be?
Malbec, definitely.
Why? I could see it. I mean, what else?
I mean, obviously, I'm
you're zesty, you're smoky.
I'm spicy for sure.
Then you'll have to come try. We got a Desenio Malbec over there. It's fantastic.
I'm all in it.
Well, cheers. Thanks so much.
Yes.
Coming up is my favorite time of day, happy hour. Hey there, I'm Just Jess of Wine Channel TV. We just had a fantastic Complexity sponsor New Zealand Wine Day, and I'm here with two guests, Pam and Frank. And what did you think of the New Zealand Pinot Noir? Is this going to be on your list to pick up?
Definitely.
Do you love the Pinot Noir as well?
I love the Pinot Noir. I love the white wine. The pairings are good with the fish, the salmon.
And the venison.
Great venison, everything. This is so smooth and so wonderful. I would definitely put it on my list.
Love it. So we should all go to New Zealand together.
Let's
do it. Yeah, New Zealand.
Yeah, woo.
Done. We're going. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers to New Zealand. So I'm here with DJ for my favorite segment, the happy hour segment. Are you having a good time here at the Chicago Food and Wine Festival? Yeah. I love it. What did you sample a bunch of things so far?
I did. I've made my way around probably through half the venue so far, so still got a little work to do.
Nice. Yeah. And I know you're a fan of ours at Wine Channel TV on Facebook, and you had a question about where to store wine.
Yes. A lot of people say keep it in the kitchen, it's okay, but I've heard that's bad.
Worst spot because of, as you'll see when we walk around, all the varying temperatures going on in the kitchen.
True.
It'll affect your wine, so keep it out of the kitchen. And then it also varies on if you have sparkling white or red. So sparkling, it should be in somewhere that's around 45 degrees. Whites, 55, red, 65. So if you have anywhere like
keep
that.
Keep it a little chill.
Keep it a little chilled. And I want to know, if you're a wine varietal, what would you be and why?
A wine what?
A wine varietal. If you're a wine, what would you be? Are you a fruity Riesling? Are you a zesty Malbec?
I would say I'm more of a champagne if I could say.
Ooh, you're a baller.
Yeah. I'll go with the champagne.
Perfect for the holidays.
Yeah.
Thanks, man.
Okay.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Stay tuned to Wine Channel TV for our Wine of the Week. So I'm here with Lumamere at the Complexity sponsor New Zealand Wine Day, and does it make you want to go visit New Zealand?
We actually used to live there.
Oh, you live
so
there?
That was what initially attracted me to the event.
So you're a true blood New Zealander, so you know that everything we talked about, you must have loved this then.
Oh, well, I've seen a lot of the places you guys were talking about when you were introducing the wines, and the genius tip is true.
What was the genius tip again?
You gotta go visit.
So when are we gonna go visit? That's the truth.
Best time is in winter time here.
So now we're talking about our wine of the week, and here I have the Blumenfeld Sweet Riesling. This is one of my all-time favorites. It's filled with heavenly sweet peach, honeysuckle, floral and citrus notes, and I thought this would be a perfect pairing with something spicy. So I was lucky enough here at the Chicago Food and Wine Festival to find Ying. Nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you too.
And I love everything that you have going on here. Tell me about your sauces and about your company.
Well, I'm an Asian cooking instructor, author. I've been teaching for over 13 years.
13
People
years.
Love my sauces. So they keep asking me to bottle my sauces. Finally, they are here. I have 10 different flavors.
10.
And this is Kung Pao. People love this flavor.
Which one is this? The Kung Pao?
Kung Pao, yeah.
That's like extra spicy. Fire.
We have extra spicy. This is mild. Just a little kick. Yeah.
But it's that'd be
perfect
good for
balance.
Me.
Yeah, perfect balance. You know, people just love this sauce. There's so many ways to use it besides just stir fry.
Right.
You can also use it as an Asian barbecue sauce.
Oh.
Barbecue ribs, chicken wings. Awesome for the holidays.
Oh, I like that.
Yes.
Great, because the holidays are coming up.
Yes.
And so speaking about holidays and food, what are you cooking here today that people are sampling?
Right now, we're doing Kung Pao chicken.
That's
Ooh. The, you know.
Perfect.
Yes.
You can't
people
beat that.
People love this, yes.
And I need to know then, since the holidays are approaching, it's going to be Thanksgiving, what's one of your favorite dishes to make with your sauces for the holidays? Like a side dish or?
You know what? We have so many different sauces. There are so many dishes you can make, you know. Believe it or not, so since we're talking about this, I just want to tell you, this is meatloaf. It's awesome.
Really?
Yes. Try it. Mm. I gave a different twist, but it's awesome.
Can I try it? But I got a steel toothpick.
Sure.
Let me get one piece.
Yep.
Of
Go
something.
Ahead. Yep, chicken.
How about a chicken and a pepper? Oh, that is good.
Yes.
And perfect with the wine.
Yes.
We gotta get you a glass
yes.
of wine.
Yes.
And then it'll be
I
a perfect
know.
Pairing.
Yes.
And where can people find out more information about you? Where are you located, Ying?
Well, you can go on my website.
Okay.
Yingskitchen.com.
Easy enough.
Yes. And we have recipes, videos. You can find me on YouTube, Ying Stoller or Ying's Kitchen. And on Facebook also.
Wonderful.
Yes.
Thanks, Ying.
We are also in 300 grocery stores, our sauces. Yeah.
Where aren't you? You're at you need to go to the wine lounge. That's
yes.
next. We
yes.
need to get you a glass.
Yes.
Thank you.
Well, thank you so much.
Coming up on Wine Channel TV, it's all about red teeth that rock. Hey there, I'm Jess Jess of Wine Channel TV, and we just had a fantastic complexity-sponsored New Zealand Wine Day, and I'm here with the woman of the hour, Sarah Burton of Cloudy Bay. You mentioned harvest is going to be a little bit later this year. When is harvest, typically?
Yeah, so harvest varies around the country, but I guess it starts up north, so it starts in Hawke's Bay in sort of early March, and then it filters down through end of March for Marlborough, and then sort of April, mid-April for the Central Otago, just based on the climate differences. So
that's great to know. If everyone wants to visit New Zealand, when you do, where to start and to go through for harvest.
Absolutely, yeah.
I love that. Wonderful. Well, thank you so much, and I look forward to seeing you again next year. Cheers.
Cheers.
So I'm talking about red teeth that rock. Come on, you can't go wrong. I have my Desaigne Malbec. It's nice and zesty. So I was looking for a perfect pairing to go with that, and I was walking by and my nose led me to you. Steve, great to see you. How are you?
I'm great. Thanks for coming.
And so first of all, tell everyone about your restaurant that you have going on.
Well, Glen Prairie, we're located in Glen Ellyn, Illinois. Our menu is 95% gluten-free, not just for celiacs anymore. Other people do come in because of the health concerns, and we open lunch, dinner, breakfast, got a great brunch located right on Roosevelt Road in Glen Ellyn. And today we brought one of our most popular dishes.
And what are you cooking up here? What do we got on this little amazing looking dish here? This is the short rib?
That's a short rib.
Nice.
You can't beat braised beef in Chicago in November.
Oh, yeah.
That's braised beef short rib, and that's done with whipped sweet potatoes. Very simple, farm to fresh table, and it's absolutely amazing. This Malbec goes amazing with it.
Perfect. Well, we got to take a little sip.
Absolutely.
A little something zesty. I love this. This is such a great value Malbec. And then this with the short rib, done and done, perfect pairing. So I need to know, the holidays are coming up. What's one of your favorite go-to wine and food pairings?
Well, I'm a Malbec lover. I love the Red Rock Malbec.
Oh, yeah, okay.
And then I also like the Cosentino Cigar Zin. I'm a red Zin.
Right.
Okay,
yeah.
As well. And moving into the winter, I mean, it's a red wine goes good with any kind of meat. So I'm a lover of wine.
You
when
have
it comes
to
down
be.
To-
and if you could have one last glass of wine with anyone, who would it be and why?
Chimney Rock Cabernet, and it'd be with my wife.
Oh, perfect.
Yes.
I love that for the holidays. That was so sentimental.
Absolutely.
Well, I'll make sure to come in and visit you, too. I'll
Absolutely.
Try to come in tonight after the Chicago Food and Wine Festival.
Absolutely.
Done.
Thank
Cheers.
You.
Coming up on Wine Channel TV is our fans' favorite wine stories. Hey there, I'm Jess Jess of Wine Channel TV, and welcome to the second annual Complexity-sponsored New Zealand Wine Day. So we're celebrating fantastic wines and Waitangi Day, and you're here, Sarah Burton from Cloudy Bay. It's an honor to have you here. And so I wanted to ask you something. I know that the big buzzwords in New Zealand is organic and biodynamic. Can you talk to me about that?
Sure. So basically, with New Zealand, it's just a beautiful, pristine country. It's you know, full of rivers and mountains and amazing scenery. And I guess what the whole idea of the organic movement is to really protect the land and really respect the land. So it's all about treating the land as something that really special. So.
And then biodynamic is planting, harvesting according to the lunar cycles.
Biodynamics is organics, but it's also about the dynamic forces of the world is like having an influence on.
Okay.
So
gotcha.
The moon, the sun, the planets, everything like that, all having a link to your land. So
when's harvest?
Harvest is about March, April, so come out in March, April. Come
perfect.
And help us. Yeah.
Cheers to that. Yes. I'm just Jess. I always say wine is just a conversation waiting to happen. So we're here at the Chicago Food and Wine Festival. I ran into Marlene, Wine Channel TV fan. Are you enjoying your red wine?
I definitely am.
And you look gorgeous.
Thank you.
Oh, you're too nice. It's all about the wine lifestyle. I mean, of course we have our great wine. You look great. But I'm asking now, Wine Channel TV fans, their great wine stories, wine-enhanced stories. So do you have any great stories around a bottle of wine or maybe the wine came after?
I love wine. I really fell in love with wine when I went to Napa Valley and there with friends and family, just drinking all day, going from one winery to the next, and you know, that's just a great experience. You drink and you talk, and just an absolutely great experience.
And I know you don't want to bring it up, but I'm going to bring it up because I met her handsome husband and they're like the cutest couple ever. And so I was like, what's a really good wine story that you've had? And he said right away how you guys met. You have to say that.
Okay, we met on Match.com. I try to hide it, but he loves to tell everybody.
That's where everything's going though now. It's internet, social media, and I'm sure you guys enjoy your bottle of wine together.
We absolutely do. When you need to wind down, a perfect bottle of wine will definitely help you out.
And now after this, he definitely owes you a couple bottles. I say that.
Absolutely.
Cheers, enjoy your day.
Thank you so much.
Stay tuned for more Wine Channel TV coming up in the Wine Skybox. Hey there, I'm Jess Jess of Wine Channel TV, and we just had a fantastic Complexity-sponsored New Zealand Wine Day, and I'm here with two guests, Pam and Frank. And what did you think of the New Zealand Pinot Noir? Is this going to be on your list to pick up?
Definitely.
Do you love the Pinot Noir as well?
I love the Pinot Noir. I love the white wine. The pairings you do with the fish, the salmon.
And the venison.
Great venison, everything. This is so smooth and so wonderful. I would definitely put it on my list.
Love it. So we should all go to New Zealand together.
Oh, I
let's do it. Yeah, New Zealand.
Yeah, woo.
Done. We're going. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers to New Zealand. So here we are, and in the wine skybox today, I'm joined by the one and only, the beautiful former master chef, Beth Peterson. Great to see you.
Great to see you too.
I have to say, I was tempted to come over here by all of your delicious goodies. So first, tell me about what you do.
Okay, well, today we have a holiday dessert buffet, but what we do is we've got an artisan cocktail party company. We cater artisan cocktail parties, and I also do cooking classes in downtown Naperville.
You do it all. I like that. And what do you have going on here? A little smorgasbord of perfect holiday treats.
We've got a lot of holiday treats here today. We've got an apple caramel cupcake and some peppermint pretzels.
Wonderful. And I see the chocolate balls, which make a perfect pairing with my little zesty Malbec that I have going on.
You can't have dessert without some chocolate.
No, of course not. Right. Chocolate and chocolate. And then you said you have some big things coming up that people should know about, big events.
Yes. You know what? Actually, I was selected by Sterling Wine for an Ultimate Hopes competition.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Really excited about that. I can't wait. It's going to be a good one.
That's so fun. And so I need to know, you're obviously a foodie. Yeah. And do you love wine or like it a little bit?
I love wine. I love wine.
Really? Yeah. What's your go-to wine varietal? If you could be a wine varietal, what would you be?
I would be Pinot Noir.
Really? Why?
I just love it.
Because it's silky, it's smooth.
Yes, absolutely. It's silky, smooth, and it's just, I just love it.
And I need to know, what's your go-to holiday dessert, I would say, food and wine pairing, if you had to make one up, that you're creating for someone?
Well, I have a really delicious double chocolate fudge cookie.
Ooh, yummy.
That I love to pair with a Cabernet.
Count me in. I'm coming over for that, by the way.
Yeah,
well, great meeting you, and I love everything I see. I'm going to have to try one of these.
Yeah,
can we
delicious.
Do a cheers with one of these?
Let's do it.
Then I'll have to get you a glass of wine.
Oh, I know.
Done. Cheers.
Cheers.
Coming up on Wine Channel TV is our Taste of the Month. You won't want to miss it. So I'm here with Lumamere at the Complexity sponsor New Zealand Wine Day, and does it make you want to go visit New Zealand?
Well, actually, I used to live there.
Oh, you live there?
That was what initially attracted me to the event.
So you're a true blood New Zealander, so you know that everything we talked about, you must have loved this then.
Oh, well, I've seen a lot of the places you guys were talking about when you were introducing the wines, and the genius tip is true.
What was the genius tip again?
You gotta go visit.
So when are we gonna go visit? That's the truth.
Best time is in winter time here.
Now we're talking about our Taste of the Month. It's a great, affordable Bordeaux blend. Here we have Mouton Cadet. And so I was thinking, what would be a perfect pairing here at the Chicago Food and Wine Festival? And I spotted you, Kent, and your amazing BBQ going on. It smells fantastic. Tell me about everything you have going on here.
Well, we're Two Fat Guys Gourmet Sauces.
I like it.
Out of McHenry, Illinois. We have a mild, spicy, smoky, and lava hot.
Ooh, lava hot.
Yes,
can I handle
it's wonderful.
It?
I think you can. I'm thinking that already. Now I'm all confused.
So you got your sauces.
But it tastes good on everything.
Really?
Everyone loves our sauces. We're a four-year-old company.
Oh, fairly new.
In about 500 store locations.
Wow, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
That's
and now
wonderful.
We're here just sampling our sauces to let people know how well it tastes and where they can buy it.
And what's the perfect pairing with your sauces? I mean, is it like wings, ribs, chicken, anything?
Well, you
that
just
people
hit
like
it all on the head. It's more of a, we call it a barbecue sauce, but it truly is a condiment. You could top a meatloaf, you could put it on a baked potato, try it on your ribs, try it on your chicken wings.
Those are all great things that would go good with this
great
wine.
Mary all,
the
also.
Smokiness. Oh, you can just switch it up. You do
you
the wine,
it
the bloody.
A little
that's
bloody
okay.
The next morning.
We're food and wine and beverage friendly. Mm-hmm. We like it all.
And this wine is wonderful, by the way. It's delicious.
It's less than $10. Can you believe that?
It's excellent.
It's Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc, and a little bit of Merlot.
Well,
and I asked you before, that's your favorite.
That's my favorite. You hit them all right on the head.
And if you could have, I want to know, one last glass of wine with anyone, who would it be?
You.
Oh, you make my day.
Look how I'm working it, huh, brother?
And where can people find out more information about you? Do you guys have a website?
You can look up ilovetwofatguys.com.
How great is that? ilovetwofatguys.com.
Yes, well, everyone loves two fat guys.
Count
especially
me
when,
in.
Especially when you're cute like I am. But, ilovetwofatguys.com.
I'll be
We'd
there.
We'd love to have you try it out or come see us at any of the shows.
I'll bring the wine, you bring the sauce.
Thank you, I could do that.
Cheers.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Coming up on Wine Channel TV, I'll sit down with some celebrities and find out what wine makes their day. Hey there, I'm Jess of Wine Channel TV, and we just had a fantastic Complexity sponsored New Zealand Wine Day, and I'm here with the woman of the hour, Sarah Burton of Cloudy Bay. You mentioned harvest is going to be a little bit later this year. When is harvest typically?
Yeah, so harvest varies around the country, but I guess it starts up north, so it starts in Hawke's Bay in sort of early March, and then it filters down through end of March for Marlborough, and then sort of April, mid-April for the Central Otago, just based on the climate differences. So
that's great to know. If everyone wants to visit New Zealand, when you do, where to start and to go through for harvest.
Absolutely, yeah.
I love that. Wonderful. Well, thank you so much, and I look forward to seeing you again next year. Cheers.
Cheers.
Never bring Mark on a boat. Mark, never, no cruises. We stay here. Got to be stationary.
I want to be on dry land.
Dry land, like here at the Chicago Food and Wine Festival.
Right. Because of a. Here's the thing. I think in a past life I drowned, and I don't want to be eaten by a shark. So if a shark can find me here, he's earned it.
I like that. Okay, fair enough.
You know what I'm saying?
I do know what you're saying. So great to see you again. I always see you on Windy City Live.
Yes.
You're rocking and rolling. You got your amazing book. Tell me what's going on with you now.
Well, we're still going strong with Windy City Live.
I love it.
I come into town about once a month for that show and have a lot of fun with those guys. and I'm doing another show in California.
Oh.
I'm traveling a lot for my book.
Right.
Wrote a movie that's being produced in March.
What's this movie about?
It's about Chicago and the blues.
Oh,
and music.
Perfect.
And I'm getting married next week.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
That deserves a little cheers.
Sure it does.
I Skull. Love that. Skull. I say salute, but I like that.
Okay, salute.
And that
wait,
one.
Wait, you didn't do it right, though. First of all, when you do it, you have to look at the person, or it's 7 years bad sex.
Really? 7 years bad sex?
Yeah. Clearly, you didn't know that rule.
Clearly.
So, think about that.
Now
Jessica.
I know. I'll remember that.
Yes, you will.
So, I need
and
to.
And then you can't, you have to drink before you put the glass back down.
Okay, I didn't put it down yet.
All right, just saying. You're a wine expert. How do you not know this stuff?
Sorry, I don't know the wine and the sex laws yet. Now I know. That's why I came over here.
Do you know the fortune cookie rule?
What? Oh, you add in bed.
Yeah.
Now I know.
I think
that.
It comes from the same guy.
It does it? It
the
must.
In bed
sex
guy is awesome.
In bed, all that. So today, obviously, we're talking about great wine. Are you a big wine drinker? I never even asked you.
I am. I'm a pretty good wine drinker.
Carlo, are you Italian?
Si.
So you gotta be a wine drinker.
See, I don't like the whites, I like the reds.
What do you think about the red blends? This is the Dave Matthews collaboration wine, Dreaming Tree. It's a red blend from Central Coast.
So this is like a jam wine?
It is. That's why it's called Crush.
Oh, I like it. So I could drink this wine for 40, 45 minutes on one glass.
Yes, yes. But that's what I want to know. Are you a big, once in a while you are?
No, I drink wine all the time. And I like, what do I like? I like the... I like the Merlots. I like
okay.
the Syrahs.
And the one
Barbosas.
Barbosa.
Not Barbosas.
Barbarescos.
Barbarescos.
Barolo. Barbaresco.
Barolo. That's what I meant.
And I want to know that we're talking about wine cribs. So instead of wine cellar, your wine crib. I mean, you're a celebrity. You're famous. Do you have a wine crib? Where do you store your wine?
I have
or
like
is
a
just in your drawer with your socks.
I have like a wine cul-de-sac. I think next to my bar, I have like a little area
okay.
where we put all our wines, best ones to the worst ones at the bottom.
I like that.
But not like a. Although I do have space under the house that I could make a wine crib. But then
there
you gotta go down there and get the wines. And
it's too far, and so I need to know
unless
though.
You do like
I do like this.
Dumb waiter.
I could do that.
Cut a hole in the floor.
That reminds me of a King of Queens episode. But okay, so holidays are coming up.
They sure what are.
And you're getting married.
Right.
What would be your wine of choice that you'd have to celebrate? I mean, what are you gonna have?
I'm gonna go with the Barolo.
The Barolo. I like that.
Big fat wine.
A big fat wine. You heard that right here. And then where can people find out more information about everything you have going on?
MarkDiCarlo.com or DiCarloInc.com.
And enter for a chance to win an amazing trip.
You can do that. I give away trips every month on my Facebook and Twitter. And what am I on Twitter? Mark_DiCarlo_ and Facebook on Mark DiCarlo.
Cheers to that. Okay.
Cheers to that.
Cheers to that. And you're, oh my goodness, now I know.
I'm trying to help
otherwise,
you out.
7 years.
Right.
Bad sex. I remember. Well, I had a blast here at the Chicago Food and Wine Festival. We tasted some fantastic wines, found out the perfect food and wine pairings, and met up with some celebrity chefs. It doesn't get much better than that. I can't wait till next year, and for more information, make sure to visit winechanneltv.com. Until then, I'm just Jess, reminding you that wine is just a conversation waiting to happen. Cheers!